I'm Ellie, and I'm Brooklyn.
And this is Mermaid Madness for the SV Seeker. These are my two special helpers. So we're almost done with her. Just got to go up to the belly, do the hands. And we pretty much got her whooped. Girls are excited about this. Enjoyable time.
All the blacks, they're basically who's at the Y. And they all know each other.
Sure.
I know it'll go back together. It means you're going to be fine.
That's so true. Yeah. Doesn't matter how bad you are the first time, you just keep doing it. It will get better. Alright, this has to be in here.
So did you drill the holes? You never put screws through them.
No, once I had the fiberglass on her, and not even the aluminum out,
yeah.
I just drilled the holes so it won't chip. There'll still be some areas we'll have to clean up on the inside, but so will.
And right through here.
Yeah.
We're actually going to drill and attach this thing to the plywood with a hole cut out just inside that. So yeah. There'll actually be a hole. We're going to flip it over.
Right, and drop it down.
And work on it in there, yeah.
Yeah.
You have longer ones?
Yeah, yeah. How much longer do you need?
An inch?
Oh, yeah.
Some days you'd catch dorado like crazy. Some days you'd catch tuna, yellowfin. Some days you'd just see hammerheads and turtles. And
I've never seen a great white, but I'm sure they're.
Okay. That's a pretty good fit.
How about the boobies? We gotta get the boobies good.
I didn't get the boobies good because it didn't fit into it. She didn't have big enough breasts, see?
Well, oh, use that other thing.
That thing will work. Oh, I'm gonna get a shot of that.
I was thinking we'd put some boards. Let's screw her down and then we'll go eat.
Well, let's okay, yeah, because we need to cut
little,
out.
Whatever little cuts we have to do after this so we can get it from the top. We have to put 2x4s on here to make this thing level and rigid.
Very nice. We took that bone growth out.
I'm guessing you're filling this seam too, right?
Yeah.
Okay, go up 2 feet.
So what's happened here is Alan made a clay mermaid and then he fiberglassed over the mermaid after he put thin metal dikes up, and those became the pieces of the fiberglass. And he drilled holes through them and put them into a UPS box, and they showed up here in Tulsa, reassembled, holes patched and seams patched up with clay, and after it was all bolted together. Now we've cut some 2x4s to the contour of the boat, which is nearly nothing at that location. Maybe, you know, 3/4 of an inch at the most. And now we're clamping those boards to the plywood, and that will put that very gentle bend in the plywood and in the girl herself. And anything else we'll just fill in later on. So if you need more explanation than that, you're going to have to go back to high school and get in his class.
It doesn't. My stuff doesn't smell.
Really?
I think we do it tomorrow.
That's not good for glass.
Five layers of glass.
That's four layers. This is good. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we'll just spray one nice heavy coat. Yeah, because we're going to need to fill the fingers with that thickener.
I'd be happy to do that.
You are. Well, just look at the hands, that's about what we're...
What's this over here?
Well, that's 16, that's what we need.
Miss Betsy's fixing our awning for next year. Shade in the summer.
Somebody ripped it.
I know, it was Mr. Wind. Looking good. That second layer just goes in a lot quicker.
I don't like that one.
I was just having us lay the pads in. The woving. Actually, it's not woving, it's how do they call it? Chop strand. Ounce and a half chop strand. Did I do good?
No, oh, stop.
How about here?
No, stop.
Oh, you're going to do the
edges.
Okay.
Over here. See this?
Oh, yeah.
Nah, I'm good.
It's just continuous is better, so we're just going to.
Contiguous?
You know, we're just going to lay it in there like that and press it in, right?
Really? We're not going to worry about the big wrinkles.
There won't be any wrinkles.
There won't be any wrinkles?
Yeah. I'll show you why.
Mix up a 16.
Are you just
13?
Yeah. So, what double that?
32, 13?
Right, and there's a fill.
Okay. Isn't that cute? Just squeeze the bottle and. All right. Oh, you didn't have to say that.
Listen. That's
I mix, but not on my aluminum. Get off my aluminum.
Okay, Bart, you too.
I've got ice water there.
No, I love that.
Go back.
That's all right. It'll work. I'm almost about to do the same thing.
Wait a minute.
That was a little scary.
Nice rack. Okay,
nice.
This is an easy fill here. See, so
yeah.
The spot there. So what?
Oh, well done.
Probably need one off.
She's sturdy.
We got a mermaid!
Earlier this morning. Certain business can't be open on Sundays. Let's turn it around. No, let me get around the head first. Certain business can't be open on Sunday. You can't, you know.
Yeah.
You can't buy alcohol on Sundays. But if you just knew what was good for you, you'd be fine, but we know what's good for you, so we're going to help you out.
Right.
Okay?
Well, we're going to tell you how it's done.
And I get to say this because I've been firmly on the other side of the bench. So
yeah.
If you do take your handle out, move it out of the way so you don't grind on it. Oh, there you go.
Your post exactly like her almost.
Well, we're trying to make love, but there's complications.
About 75 pounds, I'd say.
I'm just going to adjust the line over a little bit.
Mommy, why aren't you eating your kibble?
Can't you dogs kill the rat?
No. She's not a rat killer. Are you a rat killer? Clearly not.
Yeah, so I'm friends with the rats. I'm friends with all animals. Now I gotta throw a disclaimer in here because DeWalt gave me these discs, but I am terribly impressed with them. It's a DW8725, really thin, and you know, it was scary as hell to ride it the first time, but hadn't busted or blown apart or anything like that. I have cut one that it warped it some, so you know, putting a lot of lateral pressure on it, which is something you shouldn't do, but other than that, they've been holding up great and cut really nice, even through 1/4-inch steel. Love them. And you can trust me, if they're crap, I'd tell you so.
Get down. We're not there yet. We're getting there.
Well, that's where it goes. I'm just going to put in a block. A couple of 3 passes of weld. Thought it out, had a dream, and I decided I'm gonna cut them in half lengthwise, and they're gonna go right on the frame.
This is what Bart's up to when it's not working for the boat. He is building a tiny home. He's got all the steel framework done. Well, almost all the steel framework done. And he's putting in some more pieces today. Coming along nicely, I'd say.
I got it all leveled.
How come you can weld better over here than you can on the boat? What the hell's with that?
I'm using a $190 welder.
You need a cheap welder to weld good?
Fluxcore.
Yeah. Excellent job. So we're gonna watch Bart as he progresses through with this tiny home. Aren't we?
Yes.
I guess. If we have to.
I was gonna get some more videos.
You gonna put the bedroom up here? Is that what's up here?
Yeah.
Cool. That's a full size bed up here.
Big bed.
Big bed. Yeah. Yeah, for all you and all your girlfriends.
Bed and closet and
excellent. Porch off the back, you decided now?
Huh?
A porch off the back. Where's your patio gonna be? On the roof?
3 feet off the back.
3 feet off the back.
Yeah, just
did you put that tube there? Or was that there already? That was there already.
That was
just a license
already.
Plate
the
still.
Bumper. Oh. I'm going to bring it out about here, and then it's going to fold up.
Yeah.
So I might go 4 feet, but the back door, for the door is going to be right here also.
Right.
And it'll be 40 inches wide. It'll be a custom built door.
How many square feet have you figured out? How long is the deck itself?
22 feet.
22 feet, and you're going 8.5.
Out to the outside of the stingers.
Outside, well, how wide is the damn thing going to be?
97 inches.
That's, what was that?
8 foot.
Something?
8'5", something like that.
Right. So about 8 foot usable space inside.
Interior.
And how many, 20 something long?
22. 3 feet, so 25.
Cool. Well, you don't get to count the porch.
No. It'll be.
Yeah.
It'll be what they call.
If I wasn't building a boat, this is what I would be doing. I would be building a tiny home. Now that I live in a small home, I could even go smaller than that. And this is bigger than most people cruise the world in.
This is about 245 square feet.
Cool.
With the upper and the porch.
Right. So there you have it. If you're not doing something that cool, get to it.
The man just can't get away from grinding and welding and making noise, and my neighbor's gonna come over and go,
Been doing fiberglass all weekend, you know? You gotta get back a little steel.
There's another one on the other side.
Is there? Here we go. I think we got our pipe in the right spot. Pipe passes right here. I think we got it in deep enough now.
I think once she gets pulled in, she'll be fine.
There, I can do that.
Yeah, you'll be fine. It's perfect.
Oh my goodness, check that dude out. Are you feisty? No, you're a scaredy cat. Oh, look at those claws go up like, I'm gonna kill you, I kill you, I kill you. That's more like a crab than a spider. Better hook the gas up. That ain't coming apart. We've got a stainless steel all thread and stainless steel wire, a flux core with 100%. Oh shoot, I'm supposed to be using CO2, not argon. Wrong gas, change gas. Yeah, that's more like it.